Hi everyone, myself Arunesh and I'm happy welcoming you all with a warm greeting to the Yoga Sit Art channel. In this video, I like to share our 10 minutes common yoga protocol which will be helping in the prevention, rehabilitation and increasing the immunity and to promote the positive health as per the guidelines from Ministry of Ayush, Government of India for yoga practitioners for COVID-19. This yoga module is not restricted to any particular age group. Irrespective of the age limit, anyone can take part in this yoga module program. And maybe a few modifications can be made here and there as per the body's condition. Let's look into the practice. In this 10 minutes common yoga protocol, a list of things are covered in it. It's starting with a prayer, followed by a loosening of practice for this body. Then comes a yoga asana part, followed by a pranayama method to keep and regulate your breath better. Then comes a meditation technique, followed by an ending prayer. So now we'll try to break down it in individual sequence and look into an individual module one after the other. First one is prayer. The idea of any prayer of any religious god or anything which of that matter, idea is that we try to seek God's help, God's guidance, God's protection throughout the journey. Maybe if you are doing something as a yoga practice, we are trying to ask God for His help to be with us, to guide us in this journey and to protect us if we go somewhere wrong in between. So that completes prayer. Next part comes as a warm-up practice, or you can say loosening up practice. This loosening up practice is very important for this physical body. Because once your body is in sleeping state, maybe that 7 or 8 hours of sleep, your body will be a bit rigid, a bit tight. Energy flow will be restricted, body will become developing a bit of stiffness in it. So by doing a loosening of practice, we are allowing your joints to be functioning better basically. Here, they are given 3 loosening of practice, this 10 minutes module. First one is your neck movement, second comes for your shoulder movement, third one is a movement for your trunk. Neck movement is very important because it's the connecting part between your body and the other section, so called head. So neck, how much you keeping it relaxed, that will the connect of your body and head and the rest of the body will be. Because the energy flow from your mind, so called brain, to the entire body is taken care by this neck. So getting your neck regulated is first important thing. Second one, the shoulder movement, which is prescribed in this module. Idea is to expand the lungs better and to keep the shoulder stiffness reduced so that your daily routine will naturally feels very better and very good. Then comes the trunk, especially if you see trunk means this entire spinal cord. And a very important aspect here is that for your spinal cord, you should do 4 kinds of movement. Basically, you should allow your spinal cord to be bending right and to be bending left and to be bending forward and to be bending backward and to twist complete right and to twist completely left. This movement will be covered in this trunk exercise. Then comes a yoga asana sequence. So when we do any yoga practice, which will be fetching us enormous amount of energy from the cosmic centers, your body should be prepared, right? So we'll be going with our first yoga practice for sitting posture. The second one is in standing. Again, yoga posture lying down on your abdomen, yoga practice lying down on your back. In any yoga postures which you see, irrespective of the method of yoga practice performed, it will either expand your chest or it will be contracting your chest. The idea is to be improvising the blood flow to the body better by increasing the oxygen level by promoting the breath. So this completes yoga part. Then comes a pranayama sequence. So yoga asana are done for this body to keep it fit. Same way pranayama as a set of breathing exercises which is done to keep your mind functioning better. So to get your mind under control, you should first regulate your breath. One method which is prescribed here is anuloma viloma, or it can be said as nadi shuddhi pranayama. The name itself says that nadi shuddhi pranayama. It is believed that we have more than 72,000 energy centers in the body. Yes, 72,000 energy centers are called nadis. all these nadis and energy channels are getting purified by regulating the breath in this Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama practice. Next part comes as Dhyana. Yes, we say that yes, my breath is regulated proper, my body is aligned in a proper manner. But who knows which way you use that energy to receive? You should be having your sense organs aligned, sense organs under your control. So Dhyana practice will help you to align your sense organs in one line and to get your mind focused on a single thought again and again. It may be your favorite place or a favorite person or a favorite object. Irrespective of object or thing which you got in your mind, getting your mind repeatedly over the thought again and again, it allows your mind to be calm, allows your mind to be staying focused at a single task. So in a way, your mind will be given more relaxation. So what happens when you do get relaxation to your mind? Once your mind gets relaxed, it tries to relax your body. To tell honestly, you don't need to worry about your body at all. Imagine you got a cut in your hand. What max you can do? The best doctors of the world can treat you by applying some medicine to that. But the food which you eat for it or the medicine which you take for it will not keep praying for that. Oh my dear food, please go and rectify the cut. Or my dear medicine which I'm taking you in, please fix this nail or this injury, this stitches, whatever. No, right? We just apply some basic medicine for that and intake basic medicine can be done. That's all the best we can do. But what food you taken in, what food you consume, it itself will go heal that part, right? Correct, right? So that way, you don't need to worry about your physical body at all. Worry about your mind. Once your mind is stabilized, the mind is under control, your body's functionality will be taken care in ease. So once your mind is aligned in a proper way, it keeps your hormonal balance, it develops a sense of balance to the entire system to work in a more efficient way. And naturally, once your body and mind are coordinating with each other and when the senses are aligned in a proper line, you will be able to achieve anything in your life. Forget about all the small diseases which you come across. No matter anything, you will be able to achieve that. So this completes the Dhyana part. The last part says about ending prayer. So ending prayer is naturally to thank God for giving us this beautiful art form which is helping us to keep this body, mind to coordinate with each other, right? So this ending prayer, any prayer which you can chant, no problem. But keep in your mind that thank you God for giving me this opportunity to learn something new which is good for this body, which is good for this breath, which is good for this mind and good for so-called our consciousness. So now, the next part, we'll go for the demonstration of this yoga module which is prescribed. Let's begin with prayer. What you can do is ensure that you are sitting in any comfortable position. It can be Ardha Padmasana or it can be Shukasana this way, or even it can be Padmasana if you are very comfortable, or it can be even in Vajrasana. Like this, you'll be coming on your knee and you'll be gently relaxing. Any of this meditation practice methods, you can come. Get your body straight, aligned on a line, preferably keeping your head and spinal cord in one straight line. So here we'll start with Aum chanting. Aum is nothing but a combination of three words, A, U and Ma put together. So these three sounds will basically help you to give a complete vibration to the entire body. Starting from your lower body till your center of the head, entire body will be vibrated. So this common, as I told, it got three words in it, A, U and Ma. A sound is for the lower body and the U sound is for the mid portion of the body and the Ma Kara sound is for your head region. So we'll be starting prayer this way. Sit in any comfortable position, keeping your eyes closed, head straight, body aligned in a line. Ensure that your physical body is relaxed and away from stiffness. Breathe in. Aum. prayer, gently rub your palm, energize your palm. It is believed that as we chant prayer, we'll be receiving some energy in your palm. And apply it to your eyes gently and to your facial muscles. And drop your hands down, open your eyes and slowly look in your palm. This completes prayer. As I told you, it is for the entire body, all the three sections to get it a proper vibration. And even it is believed that chanting Aum proper will help you to rectify the problems even at the DNA level. Any problem which you're facing in your body, at the DNA level also, this Aum chanting will help you to get rectified, get overcome the issue. The next part comes as a loosening up exercise. This loosening up practice can be done in standing also. For time being, I'm just showing the sitting method, preferably. Those who can stand and do can do this practice in standing. So loosening up practice, first starting with your neck movement. Sit comfortable, hands relaxed, allow your shoulders to be free. First, as I told, it is neck movement this way. Breathe in, look up. Breathe out gently, look down. Bend your head down. Breathe in, look up. Stretching your throat. Breathing out, gently bend down, allowing your chin to lock against your collarbone. Again, gently breathe in, up. And breathe out, down. Then get your head straight, get your neck relaxed. Then gently bend your neck to the right side. Gently straight, then to your left side. Again slowly straight. Again to the right and straight. To your left and straight. Then you're going to turn your neck completely to the right side. Completely to the left side. And then gently to the right and to your left. So this practice will basically help you to loosen up your neck joint and reduce the stiffness around your neck and improvising the energy flow from your head to the rest of your body. The next practice is for your shoulder joints. As per the guidelines given, they say that you're gonna breathe in, get your hands in line with shoulder and gently drop down. Breathing in, shoulder movements, and you can breathe out, drop down. Or it can be done this way also. Breathing in, reach side, turn your palm up, get it above your head, stretch it, breathe out, get your hands down, turn your palm down, drop down. Smaller modifications can be done here. You can get your hands straight, breathe in, wide, open your chest so that you are allowing your lungs to be expanded more. You're gonna breathe in better amount of air. Breathe out, gently down, close. Breathing in and breathing out. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Slowly you can relax your hands. Ensure that you may be doing a yoga sequence or you may be doing a warm-up sequence. Ensure that your body is kept completely relaxed. Anywhere during the practice, at any point of time, you're finding uneasiness at your body or uneasiness at your breath, please stop the practice. The main idea of any yoga practice we do or any breathing practice we do, it is to get your body and mind relaxed. Yes, right? So nowhere your body should be under pressure, nowhere your breath should be under a strain. So keeping this in mind, you continue the practice. So next comes a movement for your trunk. What is given there is you're gonna get your hands in line with shoulder, you're gonna gently turn to the right side and gently turn to the left side. You're gonna turn to the right, you're gonna turn to the left. So if you're trying to understand this practice, you are twisting your spine to the right and you're gonna twist your spine to the left. So this movement, it's making your spinal cord to get it relaxed. Next comes yoga sequence. So here, as I told, there are four types of yoga sequence given. One is standing one, second one is sitting posture, third one is on your abdomen, fourth one is on your back. So first we'll start with the standing yoga sequence. Tadasana. You gently stand in your place, getting your legs together. This is called sthiti.
feet together, hands by the side, and you're going to stand with head straight. The first posture, breathe in, get your hands in line with shoulder and turn your palm up and allow your hands to raise above your head. Get it above your head, you're going to gently lock your fingers, turn it up, stretch it, eyes be focused on the same point and hands be as close as possible to your ear. Breathing in, you're going to gently come on your toes. With eyes on the same point. Complete awareness be over your breathing. Keep your joints relaxed. Keep your toes completely relaxed. Eyes on a point with relaxed inhalation, slow and complete exhalation. Once you're done with the final posture, gently drop your foot flat. Stretch your hands out once again. Allow your palm to be turned down. Stretch your hands out. Open up your palms sideways, turn your palm down, come back to sthiti. You're going to stand with legs and hands apart. So this Tadasana practice is mainly to keep your entire joints stretched and relaxed. It's like a refreshing button in the computer. Basically like that to refresh the entire system. The second practice we'll be doing now is called Ardha Chakrasana. What you do, you'll start from sthiti. Keep your legs gently aparted, maybe 1.5 feet or 1 feet gap. Get the back view quickly. You're going to stand this way, fingers together, place your hands on your waist. So, keeping your hands on your waist, legs aparted, keeping your lower body fixed straight, you are allowing your upper body only to be bent back this way. And stay comfortable in this final position. You're gonna breathe there in a relaxed way. A relaxed inhalation and exhalation. Even if it is for 2 seconds or it may be for 20 seconds or for 2 minutes. Be there in a relaxed way. At least 5 rounds of relaxed inhalation and exhalation. Gently, you're gonna come straight. And drop your hands down. You're gonna, from here, come back to sthiti. And you're gonna stand relaxed. Sthiti means default starting posture, like attention to sit. So any yoga sequence you start, if it is a standing posture, you're going to stand this way and you start to perform the yoga. As you complete the asana, you're going to end the same way, then you're going to stand relaxed. Now we'll be going for sitting yoga practice. The practice given here is called Sashanka Asana. You're going to come on your knee, grip your toes first, gently loose the grip from your toe, and sit down on your heel. And you can keep your legs together or you can apart your legs in a way it will be given a better place for your abdomen and chest to breathe. Those of you having any breathing difficulties can preferably keep your legs a bit away, hands relaxed, and gently try to slide your hands down while forehead reaching the ground. So this way you can relax your upper body to the floor. Those of you who can practice can try to reach your head to the ground, or even if it is this way, no problem, absolutely fine. Try to stay relaxed. Even if you're finding this is also difficult for you to reach, you can make fist in your palm, gently place one over the other and allow your head to be resting there. This also more than enough. See, the idea is to improvise the blood circulation to the body and to reduce the stiffness in the body, and in some way you're trying to help this body to work better. That's all. So it is not required that exactly you should replicate what I do here. So relax in Sashankasana for some 5 relaxed breathing in and breathing out. As you complete this posture, gently come up. You can sit relaxed, you can stretch your legs one after the other, and you can relax yourself this way. The next practice is lying down on your abdomen. So what you do here, you gently take your time, settle down to the ground this way. Lie down on the ground with legs and hands aparted this way. It's called Makrasana. It's a relaxing practice in lying down. Hands interlocked, legs
this way, facing the ground as much as possible. Gently allow your head, let it be preferably towards your left side, or it can be even to the right, or chin can be resting on your hands. Anything is fine. Once you are relaxed in this position, we'll start with Bhujanga Asana. What we do here, you're gonna put your legs together, you're gonna get your hands by the side of your chest, elbows close to your body. You can gently breathe in, allow your upper body to come up this way. Look up, stretch your throat, expand your chest, stay there for 5 relaxed breathing. Those of you who are finding it difficult, what you can do, you can gently place your elbow to the ground, lift it up. This is also fine as a modification for Bhujanga Asana. Preferably keeping your legs together, head up. Stretch your throat, breathe in and breathe out in a relaxed way. Once you complete Bhujanga Asana, gently relax yourself again. Get your hands, get your legs apart, normalize your breath, relax yourself. Now the next practice will be going for lying down on your abdomen. What you can do is you can gently turn towards your right side and slowly lie down on your back in Shavasana. This is called Shavasana. And those of you who like to practice with mat, please use a cotton mat as much as possible. If not, you can preferably go with the ground, no problem, absolutely fine. It will be having more interaction with the ground, which will help us to fetch more energy from the ground. So you will be relaxing in Shavasana. You come to Sthiti, once again feet together, getting your hands by the side of your body. Once you relax, gently bend your legs at your knee, place it to the ground. If you are comfortable, gently get both the legs close to you and encircle your hands to your knee, and you are gonna lift your head up, chin locking to your knee. This is called Pavana Mukta Asana. You can stay in this position as long as your breath is relaxed. Then you can gently allow your head down, ensure that you are not straining your neck or throat. Get your legs gently relaxed, normalize your breath and relax in Shavasana. Those of you finding Pavana Mukta Asana very difficult to do, what you can do is quickly show you a few modifications in it. You can gently get only one leg bent and hug your knee and try to lift your head up. This much is also fine, no problem. Then relax. Then you can gently get your left leg bent, hug with your hands, lift and reach the left, chin and slowly down and relax. And if you say even this is difficult, you can get your legs bent, comfortably place it on the ground, gently get the right, stay there comfortably and drop down, and get the left, hug your knee, reach, drop down. So this Pavana Mukta Asana practice is mainly helping us to regulate your abdomen better. So gently you come to Sthiti and relax in Shavasana. So this completes asana demonstration. Then we'll go for pranayama method. As you get out from Shavasana, what you do, come to Sthiti, gently turn your right hand above your head, turn towards your right side, using both the hand support, you wanna gently get up and sit straight. Once you complete yoga sequence, as I told you, go for pranayama. Pranayama part, as a common instruction, body should be physically fit and head straight without having any stiffness in it. It can be Shukasana this way, Ardha Padmasana or Padmasana. So sit in any comfortable position. Left hand you adopt Chin Mudra. Right hand you adopt Nasika Mudra. Second finger, third finger closed, face towards you, rest it on the knee. Now you're going to start with Anuloma Viloma practice, breathing in. After a deep inhalation, close your right side, breathe out completely through the left side.
through the left side. Close the left, hold for 1 second, open the right side, breathe out through the right. Then breathe in through the right. Close, open the other side, breathe out. Breathe in. Close, hold for a second, open the right, breathe out. Then breathe in. Hold, drop your right hand down, breathe out through both the nostrils and end the practice. This completes Anuloma Viloma Pranayama. 2 rounds can be done as a beginner. If you like to practice it for some more time, you can easily extend the practice for 5 minutes or even for 15 to 30 minutes, ensuring that your body is relaxed, your body is not having any stiffness in it, and you're able to practice at comfort zone. That's all. Next part is meditation. So what we do here, we're going to gently keep our body straight, aligned and aligned without disturbing this physical body, and also ensuring that this physical body is nowhere a disturbance to your mind. So mind can be resting in peace and relaxation for some time. So you can adapt chin mudra, or you can relax your hands this way, no problem. And gently allow your eyes to be closed. Have no other thoughts running in your mind except observing your breathing. Before you start to observe your breath, ensure your physical body is free and away from stiffness. Awareness or your breath now. A relaxed inhalation, slow and complete exhalation. Ensure that you are not having any other thoughts running in your mind except observing your breathing. If you happen to get different set of thoughts running in your mind, get your mind focused at tip of your nostrils, where when you inhale, you'll be having a mild chillness felt at nostril tip. Again, as you exhale, a warmth and a dryness will be felt. Just focus on that. Let your mind be focused at the nostril tip, absorbing the warmth and the dryness. In a way, you're trying to get your mind in the present moment with a single thought in it. Yes, I'm able to absorb my breath undisturbed. The next step, what you can do is, get your mind with a single thought. It can be a person, a place, or an object. Get a thought repeatedly running in your mind, undisturbed. Just breathe with that. Ensure that the same thought is running in your mind repeatedly. And just breathe in a relaxed way, a relaxed inhalation, slow and complete exhalation. Have no other thoughts running in your mind. Don't entertain any other unwanted thoughts except observing your breath, except keeping your mind calm and relaxed. The next part comes as the ending prayer. Once you complete the meditation techniques, you can gently allow your hands to be joining in Namaskara Mudra, if possible, keeping your body straight. So we'll chant here one prayer, one Aumkara, followed by 3 times of Shanti. with closed eyes. Breathing in. Transfer this energy to your eyes and slowly open your eyes with few blinks and look in your palm. Thank you. This completes the asana demonstration of this 10 minutes common yoga protocol. So please ensure that you follow the video in a proper order. If you have any doubts, please leave a comment below. We'll respond to it as early as possible. And regarding this common yoga protocol which I mentioned earlier from the guidelines given by Ministry of Ayush, I'll be sharing at that link also in the descriptions below. Please look into it, do practice, we'll come again with a different set of yoga video again. Thank you, stay healthy, stay happy.